Thank you, Maria. It's a pleasure to close the session and to have here the Executive Council of IFLE Europe, all the members for these days with us, and also the sponsors and all the Portuguese that came today to this session. As you all told, I must go back a little bit in the past, and it's difficult to be the last one because you have said a lot of things and talked, but it's very good to jump some slides, so don't worry. I would like to give some figures and some ideas and concepts that we had in Portugal to share with you. It was a long and difficult path, our percourse, and in Portugal we have always had a very good ecological preparation because Professor Cabral came from the University of Berlin, and we all the five programs are inside faculties of agronomic and engineer and forestry engineers, but with an important differentiation, our complementary artistic and conceptual training. The Portuguese first generation had a good collaboration with architects and engineers, but often in this time, the landscape architecture work was done by architects and engineers. So there was collaboration and there was the work done by others. The next generations, there was a balance between landscape architecture, leadership, and cooperation in design teams, but also a strong competition with other professions, biologists, geographers, planners. Okay, the planning system improvement, municipal, regional, and protected areas plans introduced a very good interdisciplinarity, and we have very good examples of this interdisciplinarity. At the government and public service structure, sometimes we had good moments, environment and planning at high levels, ministers and so on, and we had terrible decisions, merging services, some steps back, so it was really difficult. But the number of landscape architects in public services always increased, and the private office multiplied around the country. Municipalities, I believe, I shared this some weeks ago, the municipalities are more aware about landscape architecture, sustainability, ecological-based solutions, but they still have huge compromises with private interests. Our legislation system has been for a long time quite complete, pioneer, and adequate, but the compliance with legislation and regulations and also monitoring are very poor sometimes, and government and local authorities often resorting to exceptions. Our laws are full of exceptions, escapatories, you can observe in our country many interventions in inappropriate places. This lack of compliance we had also a lack of compliance on the part of private individuals, designers and planners, often trying inappropriate locations and going beyond urban planning rules and parameters. When I thought about the characterization of the landscape architecture, I remember that in 2010, we insisted to have a chamber. It's a long, long fight we have in Portugal, and we asked the Research Center for Agronomic Institute and also a lawyer to prepare a dossier to give to the Parliament. Now the Parliament is like this. Many, many years we are fighting for a chamber, but this characterization, it's quite complete, so I just use it. The work was coordinated by Professor Manuela Raposo Magalhães, and I updated some issues. We can say that in the 40s, Caldeira Cabral defined the profession in Portugal. Landscape architecture is the art of organizing outdoor space in relation to man. As in many other countries, it was in force in Portugal the neoclassical style, and the School of Landscape Architecture set out to work with nature and not against it, as we heard this morning this phrase. And we try to have an in-depth knowledge of the natural science, not sectorial or specialized, but in a relational way from the perspective of the new science of ecology. It sounds to you, everybody talks about this today, but we are in the 40s. So my point is that we are in the 40s. Intervention based on scientific ecology, knowledge of environmental factors and their interrelationships. And for Caldera Cabral and the first generation of professionals he trained, this knowledge of ecology was always coupled with a deep understanding of the culture and that had worked the land in Portugal and all over and built up the heritage. So the main innovations in the 40s, I insist, the first landscape architects in Portugal start around 1949, and they are pioneering the integration of ecological and cultural principles, working in multidisciplinary teams. We didn't talk about interdisciplinary, it was almost multidisciplinary teams. The combination of new concepts with traditional elements, a naturalistic aesthetic concerned with the location of functions. This was always very important in Portugal, depending on ecological suitability. The vegetation that they are using, it was natural or traditional vegetation, replacing the taste for the exotic that it was all over the 19th century, very loved. So annual plants was minimized and replaced by perennial to reduce the maintenance and allowing for larger recreation urban green spaces. The concept you heard this morning of natural continue, using the ecological principles of continuity, diversity and intensification, which was many years after translated into the Portuguese legislation in 1987 as fundamental law of the environment. But it was used in the 40s. Rarely we use the monofunctional zoning as proposed by the Athens Charter. Sorry, Catarina, the Athens Charter, we didn't use very much. And that the Roads Department start the concept of landscape integration and the use of native vegetation to stabilize slopes. So we believe that we heritate the best of the modernist period, useful science-based architecture founded on knowledge of natural processes, but which did not reject culture as a factor in the design of space. The aesthetics of this space created were naturalistic. In 1958, it was created the first landscape architecture service. It was in the General Directorate of Urbanization Services and began the first phase of the integration of landscape architecture graduates into the central administration, following their participation in the project. We are well known in project and design, but in central administration, it's just starting. 65, the collaboration of landscape architects in the Lisbon Region Master Plan. 66, the first landscape architect alone, he was alone at the roads service. And the 68, in the work of the Mozambique Settlement Board. In 1974, you know that we had our revolution, and immediately after, Professor Ribeiro Teles entered the government, first as Secretary of State for the Environment, and later as Minister of Quality of Life. So we had the chance to have Caldera Cabral coming from Berlin University, and then we have the chance to have a landscape architect that was a political man, and he had the chance to define new policies, particularly in the field of nature, it started with nature conservation, land use management, and the environment. So he approved, he achieved to approve important legislation, the Network of Protected Areas, 76, National Agriculture Reserve Protecting the Best Soils in Portugal, 82, National Ecological Reserve, 83, and the Principles for the Regional Special Plans in the 80s. The generation graduated in the early 70s, and the professionals who followed them played an important role, a large number of private studios designing numerous projects, and particularly in land use planning and the management of protected areas. In the 90s, landscape architects managed to get a Portuguese law include, it was very important, an ecological structure at all levels of planning, including urban space. This ecological structure has been applied at national level and also at municipal level. The example Catarina Freitas didn't present today, but the Lisbon municipal plans all have this ecological structure. It constitutes an essential piece of Lisbon plans since 1995, and the municipality implemented through numerous detailed plans and projects designed by landscape architects. Luís Paulo present one of the, that's why we chose Luís Paulo to present today, because the municipality hired several colleagues, there are several here in the room, to pursue the ecological structure. So the main places in Portugal, the top hills and the basins, are object of, in Lisbon, are object of detailed plans and projects. A huge number of plans are now giving place to the Lisbon municipal plan and green chart. So all these activities passed on to the political level, the ecological-based vision that would lead Lisbon to the designation of Lisbon Green Capital in 2020. The role of spaces, commonly known as natural spaces, in the sustainability of the urban environment, defended by Portuguese landscape architecture, recognized internationally, and are in line with the continued appearance of various European communications and directives. Introduction of innovative concepts and methodologies by landscape architects in Portugal. It's a path towards the sustainable development required by the European laws. The last 30 years, also mobility, soft mobility at municipal level plans were developed. So we have the map of potential ecological landscape, the national ecological structure, prepared by the Research Center of Agronomic Institute. And in 2020, it was launched the new European Bauhaus by the European Commissioner, Ursula von der Leyen, and she invited the European Council of Architects. And the European Council of Architects invited IFLE Europe to join. And they asked IFLE Europe for some projects to show our works, in what field we are working. So IFLE Europe sent to the new European Bauhaus a project from France, a Dutch, a Polder, so some kind of Polder in Netherlands, and some Portuguese projects. So we sent the potential ecological landscape, it's the map on the right, and also the Scape Fire, a sustainable landscape planning model for rural fires prevention. So it was recognized and sent at the European level. I think someone showed this map. The the ecological structure for Lisbon, trying to link the valleys, the huge Monsanto park, and the corridors, and also along the river Tagus. So the indications that express the innovative nature, urgency, and timeliness of ecological-based plan advocated by the Portuguese School of Landscape Architecture, I insist, correspond to the concerns currently being addressed by the European Union, the danger of monospecific pine and eucalyptus forests, now being vindicated by the scale of the forest fires that ravage the country every year, but also the renaturalization of rivers and streams in line with the community directives and the Portuguese law water policy, and also the defense of the sustainable use of soils of high ecological value and of agriculture named urban agriculture. An example of a plan for a project for a small village near Lisbon, maintaining the flood plain, for sports grounds, agriculture, avoiding urban floods. Ribeiro tells designing and trying to convince mayors, ministers, so he got mad and he tried to design very strongly, very expressive, showing the RAN, its National Agriculture Reserve, RAN, its National Ecological Reserve, the place for the buildings, so to show and to convince about these issues. You are going to see tomorrow the Gulbenkian Park. And in education, just to compare some figures. So we have the first programs in the United States and Japan, 29 Germany, 40s United Kingdom and Portugal. So in Portugal, 41 Lisbon, 75 Évora, 98 Algarve and Trás-os-Montes, 2001 Porto and the private school. All these programs are recognized by the Portuguese Association of Landscape Architects and were based on the standards established by European Foundation at the time, EFLA directives. All our programs are hierarchically organized, bachelor 3 years, master 2 years, doctorate 4 years. So the Portuguese Association of Landscape Architects needed to prepare a directive for the assessment of these programs. It is in use since 2010. I'm going on because just the middle sentence to highlight the aesthetic approach. So Professor Cabral pointed out that the artistic solution, distinct from the merely technical solution, due to the breadth of its conceptions, by taking into account the need for synthesis, it expresses a beauty that mere technique never achieves. Landscape architecture in the world, you know that in the 1858, Olmsted and Vaux used the name of landscape architects. They called themselves landscape architects. And some years after, they prepared the foundation of the American Society of Landscape Architects, followed by the German, the Dutch, the Landscape Institute, the Norwegian Association, and the Portuguese one in 76. The need to create synergies and to relations between these professional associations create the International Federation of Landscape Architects in 1948. And Professor Cabral joined IFLA in 51 as Portugal representative, and it was followed by a regular participation of landscape architects in this federation. So Professor Cabral was vice president in the 57 and president 62 to 66. If European Foundation for Landscape Architecture was set up in Brussels in 1989, and Portuguese participation was continuous, always belonging to the education and professional practice committees, and our colleague Teresa Anderson was the president from 2004-2008. Other, in this, the same vein, other organizations, ELASA, in 1990, was born in Portugal, Évora and Lisbon universities, and the year before, and then in Budapest in 1990, ECLAS, the schools organization, 91, Le Notre Institut, and also Uniscape. So Évora, the first meeting, Professor Cabral in the bottom, addressing the students, and the General Assembly that created ELASA. After the landscape, European Landscape Convention in 2000, following this, we prepared at the University of Évora a document, the contribution to the identification and characterization of landscape in Portugal, Alexandre Cancela de Abreu and Rosário Oliveira, in 2004. And it was followed by the National Plan for Territorial Planning in 2007, which states at the first objective, protecting and enhancing landscapes and cultural heritage. And it was followed by a National Policy on Architecture and Landscape in 2015. So this is the study from the University of Évora. And over the last four decades, it has contributed to the institutional visibility of the profession, APAP, the Portuguese Association, the recognition of higher education programs, the political debate on interventions in the landscape, in the planning process, in the legislation, and representing Portugal at international associations like IFLA and IFLA Europe. So, it was a long journey, pioneering spirit, innovation, dedication. We had many struggles, but many achievements. We are facing new challenges, natural, social, and political challenges, but we have a large number of professionals well prepared, international relations and international recognition. We need to reach more our politicians and integrated more national policies. That's why we need this conference, and we are so grateful that you came to help us to spread this message. Thank you. Thank you.